I'm Bridget Pruitt, representative of Ecodrum through Hindsite Solutions Sales and Service. We're here at the University of Arkansas Broiler Research Farm conducting training videos for the use of the Ecodrum Composter. This video includes information on the proper recipe ratios that should be used in the operation of your Ecodrum. Please note that due to the variables in every composting situation, the purchaser alone is responsible for the operation of the Ecodrum according to the U.S. Composting Council standards. When deciding on bulking material, there are a couple of key things to keep in mind. The material should be dry, high in carbon, and be made up of a variety of different textures. We recommend using wood shavings like these, but we have also had success in the past with materials such as peanut hulls and cross-cut corn cobs. Please contact your Ecodrum representative before trying any unadvised materials. The general rule for composting in the Ecodrum is to maintain a 2-to-1 ratio between your bulking material and your mortality. In the case of poultry carcasses, for example, this would mean that for every 1 bucket of mortality, 2 buckets of bulking material would be added. This ratio can be slightly modified, however, when dealing with lighter birds. For below 5 pounds, the ratio can be modified to 1.5 buckets of bulking material for every single bucket of mortality. When dealing with larger animal mortality, such as swine carcasses, we measure the ratio in entire bags of shavings as opposed to pails or buckets. In these cases, the ratio tends to work on a sliding scale. For mortality up to 125 pounds, an entire bag of shavings would be used. For carcasses ranging between 125 pounds and 250 pounds, 2 bags would be used. And for animals weighing in at over 250 pounds, 3 bags of shavings would need to be added. Finally, when loading mortality and bulking material, it is important to add those components in the correct order. Bulking material should always be added first, followed by the mortality. This prevents those pockets of excess moisture, which can lead to odors and inefficient composting. This concludes the training video on the maintenance of your Ecodrum composter. If you have any further questions, please feel free to click on the links provided to our other training videos on a variety of topics, or email us at info@ecodrumcomposter.com.